Hello and welcome to Before Exams. Here we help you to prepare for your competitive examinations. Subscribe to our channel so that whenever we post the content about your exam, you get the notification about it. Hello and welcome to this part of IELTS Speaking. In this section, we'll be learning about part 2 of IELTS Speaking, which is the most important part. In this section, you have to speak for at least 1 to 2 minutes without interruption. And the candidates find this part as the most difficult one. So that is why I have included this part, especially to help you how to attend this part and how to get the maximum bands out of this part. So let's just see that what we'll be doing in this section. We'll be learning, first of all, the overview of IELTS Speaking Part 2. Then we'll be learning how you should frame your answer so that you can speak for that stipulated time or the desired time which you have been asked to speak for. And then there will be a homework exercise. Now, IELTS Part 2, in this, there is 3 to 4 minutes which is allotted to you. How these 3 to 4 minutes are divided, we'll just be learning about this. Now in this, you will be given a cue card, and in that cue card there will be a question. Also there will be some hints to it, so that you can use those hints to include in your speaking. You will get 1 minute to prepare your notes. Not more than 1 minute. You'll get exactly 1 minute to prepare your notes, and then you have to speak for around 1 to 2 minutes. You have to speak for at least 1 to 2 minutes. It lasts between 1 minute 30 seconds to 2 minutes, depending on the examiner. So the examiner will not be interrupting you. You will be speaking continuously. Now, the common topics which are asked in IELTS speaking section part 2, these are the topics which are very commonly asked, but you should not think that the question will be from these topics itself. There will be questions from other topics also. There are hundreds of topics from which they give you the question. But these are some general topics from which the questions are asked. So it's people, friends, places, any of your experience, hobbies. They'll ask you to describe some hobby, a habit, event. They'll ask you to describe an event in which you went, an object, feeling, then art, books, then communication, any gift that you gave to someone or you receive from someone, exercise, music, what kind of genre you like and something about that, photograph, sports and journey. So these are some of the common topics from which the IELTS speaking section 2 is given. Okay, so this is an example of an IELTS speaking section 2 cue card. This is the same cue card that you will be getting. It will be the same format that you will be getting in your test. So this says, describe a book that you have recently read. Now you should say what kind of book it was, what it was about, what sort of people would enjoy it, and explain why you like it. Now the thing is, a question is asked, or what you have to do is you have to speak for around 1 to 2 minutes, and there are some hints which are given. So what you can include is, you can include what kind of book it was, what it was about, what sort of people would enjoy it, and explain why you liked it. So this will really help you to frame your answer. I would suggest you to always write notes on these points or hints which are given, because these are the hints for which you do not have to think about. You do not have to think about that what you will speak. The hints are already given. The only thing that you need to do is you just need to give the answer of these questions. This will really help you to frame your answer and will help you to speak for around 1.5 to 2 minutes. Your aim should be that for every point, you should speak for at least 10 to 15 seconds. This will really help you to speak for 1.5 minutes. That is the desired time for which you have to speak. Now let's see how you can go ahead and how you can frame your answer. So there is a W rule that I personally recommend the students and I personally use so that I can frame my answer, because I have only 1 minute and I have to prepare my notes. It will be really difficult for me to think and to prepare notes for it, to think of the points that what I will be speaking. So what I have done here is I follow a W rule here, wherein what I do is I have some questions in my mind. I just write the answers of this. You'll get an idea. Let's just read what W rule is. So W rule, in W rule, there are some questions that we ask. First is what, where, when, why, and who. So what you can do is you can make notes of these. Whatever is asked, what it was, where it happened, when it happened, why it happened, and who was the person who did it or who did it. So this is the rule which will really help you to frame your answer. Let's see an example of it. We'll be learning about the same example. Describe a book you have recently read. There are some hints. Now, let's just frame our answer. What I can do is, first is what. In what book did I read? It was Rich Dad, Poor Dad. I like reading self-help books. When I read it? Last month, as I had free time. Where did I read it? I read it on a business trip, had a lot of free time after 2-hour meeting daily. Why did I read it? Because I was struggling with finance problems at that time. Who wrote it? Robert Kiyosaki. And I like his books. Others' contribution are Why the Rich Are Getting Richer, Guide to Investing. So these are some of the points that you can use. See, this is a really nice way to frame your answer. By just making this table, you do not have to make this fair table. What you can do is you can just make a rough table, and rather than using the full words, what, when, where, why, and who, you can make some signs or signs of your own, and then you can use it so that you can write maximum points in that 1 minute time. Also, you can use your shorthand writing. You can make some words, some symbols of some words that you can use while writing these notes. Right. Now, let's see in another example. Describe a gift you recently gave to someone. You should say who you gave it to, what kind of person he or she is, what the gift was, and explain why you chose that gift. What I'll do here is I'll give you some time. Just make notes of your own. I'll give you around 10 seconds. And then we'll look at how many questions you were able to answer and how many questions you were able to make notes. Okay, so your time starts now. Okay, time up. So let's just see that what notes we could have made from this question. What was the thing that I gave, or what was the gift that I gave? It was a cycle. Then you can give the description of cycle, that it was a blue cycle, the make of the cycle, the company, what was so different about that cycle. You can use those words. You can use those things to really frame your answer. When did I give it, or when did I gift it? I gifted it last winter when it was freezing cold temperature. So you can use these things, that it was last winter, freezing cold temperature, and then you can elaborate these things. Where? Idukki. This is a small town in Kerala, close to nature. So you can use that. This was my hometown, Idukki, wherein I gave I gifted this cycle. Then you can explain about the hometown. Why? I gave it to my niece. I promised her if she scores A+ grade in her final exams, I'll give her the cycle. And who did I give it to? I gave it to my niece, 8 years old. Now the thing is that you do not have to write, or you do not have to frame the answers in the same order. No. So in this, if you'll see, what you have to do is you have to first of all tell what the gift was and who you gave it to. So frame your answers according to that. Otherwise, it will be in a haphazard manner. So this is something wherein you can just use that. What you can just make notes that what are the answers of these questions, and then you can use the symmetrical order, whatever you want to choose. Okay, so let's just see an example. Let's just look at an example that how you should write. Now we looked at that how you should make your notes. Now let's look how you can frame your answer with that, with those notes. So let's just go ahead and see. So we'll see that only. Describe a book you have recently read. This is all what you should include, and this is what the notes that we made. So let's just see that what we can do to frame our answers. Well, that's a pretty good question. Books are what I like to read whenever I have free time. The idea of improving myself in free time really fascinates me. And there is no better way to improve by reading a self-help book. Recently, when I was on a business trip for a week, I had a lot of free time on a daily basis after a meeting with my client. I decided to utilize the time by reading Rich Dad, Poor Dad, written by Robert Kiyosaki. I have previously read Why the Rich Are Getting Richer and Guide to Investing, written by him. And honestly, I was really amazed by his presentation skills, which encouraged me to read this book. It is a great self-help book, which guides you about the ways to manage your finances. I too was struggling with my finances, and this was also the reason I took up this book. While reading the book, I figured out that it is not very difficult to become rich. It is just that you need to spend, invest, and reinvest smartly. The book also taught me the ways to utilize the available resources in the best possible manner. I would really suggest everyone to read this book once, especially for those who are just starting their career. It will really teach them to manage the cash inflow, which will be very fruitful for them in the future. So this is how I framed the answer. I was able to speak for the stipulated time, and also I used these notes which I made in that 1 minute time. Right. Also, do not try that the notes that you have written, do not always just read out those notes. Those notes are to frame your answer. It is not just that. So it's not like, let's take this point. What? So what book did I read? I read Rich Dad, Poor Dad. I like reading self-help books. Now this kind of answer, if you'll just speak from your notes, this will end your answer in 10 to 15 seconds only. You'll be able to read the points in 10 to 15 seconds and your answer will end. The thing is, you need to elaborate those things. So I liked reading, took up this Rich Dad, Poor Dad, and I have been reading these books. Why you read that book, make a story that why you chose this Rich Dad, Poor Dad. Making stories will really help you to frame your answers for those 2 minutes. So what you have to do is start practicing to make stories out of nowhere. Just what you have to do is you have to look at the things around you and start making stories about them. Their story should last at least for 2 minutes to 3 minutes. Because if you'll be able to speak for 2 to 3 minutes without any issues, then it will really be a cakewalk for you to speak for around 1.5 to 2 minutes in your speaking exam. So this is a practice that you can do on daily basis to improve your speaking skills. This will not only help you to improve the speaking skills, but it will also help you to gain confidence. Right. So this is all about the speaking part too. Now there is an exercise, a homework exercise. For that, you know, you have to mail me on the email address given in the link. I'll be mailing you the assignment, and then you have to do that. Okay. So this will be it for now. I hope you really enjoyed it. You now have the idea how to attempt the question, which is in part two. Have a great day and continue enjoy learning. Bye-bye.